out of them.
After I left Creedmoor, things got kinda funny. Then I ran into my man, Theodore Bundy. I think he went to law school, most certainly harmless. He had a cast on his arm with a sling and a harness. He had a girlfriend, but you would never suspect that he liked to kill girls, cut them up, and have sex.
For the record, you are guilty of killing many women and girls. Yes.
They locked him up once. The crazy fool promptly escaped. Went straight to a nursing school, committed more murders and rapes. By the time he got the chair, it was far too late. At least 30 women had already met this horrible fate. How did this keep happening? How did this keep happening? It's a broken system, so now I only take the ones that I know, the one who missed them. No one will miss them.
No one.
After I first get them, I tie them up and I kiss them, and keep them for myself as they cry their faint wishes. For a bit of police assistance, or beg for their freedom, as if I'll dismiss them that easy after all the trouble it took just to lure them here. So believe me, no one here gets out alive, because I treat homicide like it's a 9-to-5. I keep trophies for everyone I got. I cut scars on my chest, my house smells like rot. I'm always on the clock, out prowling for victims of big box parking lots. I'm in a Volkswagen. So much we yell, do whatever you need to. But baby, never get in my Beetle. Never get in my Beetle. Never get in my Beetle. Punch me now, do whatever you need to. But baby, never get in my Beetle. Never get in my Beetle. Matter of fact, run. So if you see a beat up tan 68 Beetle, backseat removed, pretty good looking guy, wearing a cast, might be asking for a little help. Why don't you give him a hand?